Hey guys! So, natural gas. It brings warmth and coziness to our homes, holds up the economies of the world's largest countries, and today, it is the main fossil fuel in the world. But, you may be wondering, how is it delivered to the far-off corners of the planet? Gas pipes are more often than not used for this transport. But what do we do if we need to transport the gas to a different continent, not just a different country? We use unbelievably complex, gigantic ships called gas tankers. Transporting liquefied natural gas across the seas has been done since the 1950s, but of course, not always in special ships. Luckily for world energy, methane can be in both a gaseous and liquid state. It thickens by about 600 times at low temperatures or high pressure, and its appearance resembles water. That's how we decided to use modern transport ships. The liquid gas is poured into huge ocean tankers thermal containers and is transported around the world. Now, if one of these tankers transported methane in its typical gaseous state at atmospheric pressure, then the ship would need to be about 106 miles long to transport the same amount. However, these ships are by no means small. So these ocean monsters are made in the world's largest shipbuilding dock in South Korea. The construction of one ship takes about 2.5 years. 75% of all the tanks that transport liquefied natural gas today are made in South Korea, a country that historically generally never was a naval superpower, but has always been praised for its hardworking and diligent workers. So the workday at the shipbuilding dock that is about 32 million square feet begins at 7:30 a.m. Several hundred buses bring the workers to the central entrance, and about 10,000 more come on bicycles. Perfect order and a meticulous, almost military-esque precision in carrying out their instructions are the main principles of their work. Everything should be like clockwork. The total weight of one tanker is several times heavier than the Eiffel Tower. These iron ships are designed and built with the idea that they will displace a mammoth amount of water when in the water. The weight of the water displaced is equal to the weight of the fully loaded ship. This is called water displacement. In the end, the Archimedes principle is equal to the weight of the tanker, so it doesn't sink. However, the ship isn't near being ready to sail yet. First, the steel sheets need to be cut into thousands of workable pieces. 75 machines work on the gas cutting line, and each of the computers in the machine has a program. It turns out the worker's job is only to pull the cut segments out and push the start button on the controls. After all the necessary parts are cut out, they are sent to the bending section. A ship's hull is actually a huge amount of curved lines connected to the ship's aerodynamics. Oncoming air and water flow should flow around the ship, which means right angles should not be present. The properly cut curved sheets of metal are assembled into small constructions. The next section makes larger constructions out of them. And then they are used to make huge sections as tall as a house and weighing several tons. The sections are called large blocks, and there will be 98 of them in one tanker. The creation of these blocks is the most important part of the construction. Each one should perfectly fit in its place. The margin of error for these pieces is less than 1 millimeter, 0.04 inches. Meanwhile, the ship's total length is 925 feet. The total distance of welding on one ship is about 373 miles. So after these massive sections are ready, they are sent from the shops to an open area. They are then assembled into 6 mega blocks that will then make up the entire ship. Now, the creation of 1 mega block requires about 16 sections. They are welded together over several months, resulting in a huge chunk of the ship weighing 3,000 tons. These pieces just need to be properly put together now. But how can you drag these 6 mega blocks to the dry dock, where they will become one whole? This task is too difficult for even several powerful cranes. However, a floating crane that can lift 3,200 tons can handle it easily. The floating crane carefully pulls these unimaginable pieces for whatever distance is required. This operation is prepared for usually for several weeks, taking the wind, waves, time of day, and many other facts in mind. After all, 6 pieces of the ship are welded to each other. The dry dock is filled with water, and the ship sets sail. This is when it becomes a ship, but its construction is still far from over. To become a tanker, it still needs its most important feature, massive storage for liquefied natural gas. The total amount of energy stored in the liquefied gas for the ship's four tanks is equal to 60 of the type of nuclear bombs that were used in Hiroshima. It's scary to even just imagine. What would happen if all that energy weren't under control? The smallest gap between sheets, or a crack the size of a human hair, could lead to a liquid gas leak and an explosion. The thousands of square feet of steel membranes and miles of welding should be perfectly sealed. The workers accurately lay one sheet to another and then weld them together with an extremely accurate laser. Now, after the outside is finished, the entire interior surface of the huge tank looks like a single piece. It's an unbelievably durable giant thermos that is capable of holding immense pressure and super low temperatures. It takes an entire day to completely empty this monster's tanks. 50,000 tons of liquefied natural gas can fit in one supertanker's four tanks. So the heart of the tanker is the colossally powerful internal combustion engine. It actually has several of those hearts, and each is the size of a two-story home. The fuel requirements of those giants are 2 tons of diesel fuel an hour. But the engine has a curious quirk. It can use both diesel fuel as well as natural gas, specifically the gas that the ship is transporting in its tanks. That means when the ship is moving, it burns its own cargo for energy. Theoretically, with all the fuel on board, the tanker could completely autonomously stay at sea for several years. And this is kind of surprising. The ship is helmed by only 20 people. So the crew is made up of engineers, operators, and programmers. Now, the lion's share of the processes on the ship are run by computers. They control absolutely everything, from the climate system in the cabins to the navigation. The cockpit of this modern ship looks more like a flight control center, a ring of computers and monitors all feeding off of electricity. Now, the only remaining ship-like attribute on board may be the steering wheel, but it's not so simple. It doesn't steer the ship directly. If you turn the wheel, it sends a signal to the onboard computer, which decides how to correctly turn this gigantic beast. Now, after the tanker is fueled, it carries its giant cargo of highly dangerous substances across the ocean. Additionally, gas tankers are very peaceful ships, since they are one of the most complex technological projects in the history of humanity. They also carry such simple and crude natural gas, which means they are bringing people warmth and electricity. Well, that's all for today. Be sure to leave us a like, don't forget to subscribe, tell me the most interesting thing you learned from the video, and we'll see you again next time.